So what to make of the Tom King Catwoman Batman series? I think it will be Batman Catwoman, but who knows? They could switch it up. Well, here's some thoughts. Hey there, this is Perch. I should call this Driving with Perch, because that's what this is, Driving with Perch. That's what's going on here. Yeah, you're making my commute more enjoyable, folks. Thank you. I deeply respect it. That's why I don't monetize, because you're doing me a valuable service already. Anyway, Tom King leaving Batman, the main title, early to kind of switch it up, and we'll be doing the 12-part Batman Catwoman series in a nice 12-part comics in a wrapper, similar to Mr. Miracle and The Vision and some of the other things he's done. There will be more. Tom King seems to, or at least the company has decided, Tom King is really good at the 12-issue kind of micro-series, mini-series, whatever you want to call that. I'm driving like a maniac here. I'm going to get honked at. Part of the problem is, you know this when you're driving and the road's ending, so you got to merge in. And most people, they understand the concept of the zipper, and the zipper is where, the main road is going, one person in, then a car, then one person in, then a car. And if people drive like, there's been scientific proof that if they drive that way, then traffic is smoother, there's fewer delays, life is really good. But unfortunately, humans are a-holes and they don't like to drive that way. And so there's a competition to kind of close the loop in the zipper and not let people in. But if you're me and you're doing like a comic video, you just kind of just tilt the wheel to the left and hope for the best. And, you get in there and then you get people behind like, my fiendish plan has been spoiled. And they're shaking their fist at me. Anyway, no horns. So that's good. This is what you tune in for, by the way. A regular topic that gets absolutely derailed by something else. Anyway, the Tom King Batman Catwoman arc, somebody at DC determined that was what Tom King was good at, was these 12-issue runs. And I think that's true. I think Tom King does well under that scenario. I think that somewhere along the line, people are like, hey, Matt Fraction kind of did that sort of ish run. And then Tom King did the 12-issue run. And 12 issues are two trade paperbacks and one big hardbound collected edition. And we can make some money off that. It's a good format. I think that they believe Tom King is that kind of writer. And so I think you'll see DC struggle to use Tom King in an ongoing book again. Now, since I say this, and whatever the 3 months it takes for this video to finally air, they'll have announced him as a new writer on, Superman and Justice League and everything else. And, this will sound stupid. But I do think that at least there's some I know that there's some recognition within the publisher that 12 issues are what Tom King's good at. So he's doing the Batman Catwoman run. It's designed to be kind of a cap to his Batman series in general. I think that, I've lost kind of some faith. My initial belief was that they were going to pay off the Batman Catwoman marriage, and they were going to tie them together and have them get married, and that was what this was going to be. I'm starting to think no, they're not going to go down that path. They're going to kind of do the modern artistic thing of like, well, we're going to be in a relationship, but that's we're going to be exclusive-y, but not completely exclusive. And if the issue calls for it, then we're going to be with somebody else. And we're going to create that dynamic. And unfortunately, a lot of the comic publishers believe that marriage is like a lead weight around the neck of the characters. And what I don't think they realize is this kind of in between, sort of where Mary Jane is now with Spider-Man, but more where it feels like Bat-Cat is going, is they don't have them get married. They have them kind of they're sort of in a relationship, but not really in a relationship, but kind of they're in a relationship and everything else. And then, in their solo books, Catwoman will run across some, super hot guy. And she's like, oh, I think I might, sleep with this guy, but I don't want to because of Bruce, but maybe I should. And I don't know. And that's more of a lead weight, I'm telling you, than the marriage. The marriage would be less of a downer, less of a lead weight of comics. It's just been played out. I always feel like the people in comics, the writers and the editors, are kind of the last ones to figure out that some things are just tired. Some concepts have been done and done and done, and the readers know where it's going. They don't even have to pick up the issue. They can tell, here's where it's all headed. And the comic writer's like, I'm doing something new and fresh. And I know this is kind of true because I've gone to many cons over the years, and you'll have those panels. And the people, like the fans, will get up and ask, you know, there's always like two questions that come out in almost every panel. One is like the super obvious question, like, I was just wondering, you know, what you thought about Batman and Catwoman together. Like, that's a dumb question. I mean, that's going on. There's, you know, that old thing that's used to say in school, there's no dumb questions. There are tons of dumb questions. Most questions are dumb. But anyway, there's that question. Then the other one is always like some bizarre, you've never heard of it before, kind of either ethnicity or gender preference or something comes out. Like, when is Hawkman finally going to acknowledge polymorphism as a sexual preference? And then you get to watch like the writers up on the panel. And this is always where you're going to a con, you spend all this money. Why not give the audience something new? Why not go, hey, that's stupid. Shut up. No. But go ahead. I mean, it is just, they think you're stupid. So I've hung out with writers and artists and people after the panel. And you know how, if you've ever been to a con, you know how sometimes maybe you go by a bar or a restaurant and you see a bunch of the creators sitting there. You're like, oh, wow, they're all sitting there. And they're talking together. I wonder what they're talking about. I bet they're planning a story. No, they're talking about your dumb questions at the con. I promise you, this has happened so many times. They're like, hey, can you believe that one dumbass who asked about if we were going to feature, when were we finally going to feature a superhero and Avengers that comes from St. Kitts in the Caribbean and really dive into, you know, their heritage and, you know, stop misrepresenting people from the southeastern Bahamas Caribbean region. And it's like, come on, they make fun of you. That's what they do. Sorry, this video has turned kind of negative. Anyway, Batman Catwoman, I think you'll get a nice 12 issue series. I think it's fine. I think it'll probably be a nice showcase for King, especially if he's walking into it knowing he's got a very clear beginning and end. He can do his beats. I do think it's going to be kind of a introspective kind of look at the relationship and the dynamic between the two of them, which I'm not sure anyone's really asking for at this point, but why not? I would hope that they would end with a marriage, but I feel it's more like they're just going to end it in kind of ambiguity, limbo land, and that's where it's going to sit. And that's fine, you know, wherever you want to put it. But I would love it if this series kind of decided to take the bull by the horn. And I had a plural and then I went away from it. The bull by the horns. There you go. You got to say these things proper. And really kind of gave a good definitive, you know, the end to the series. You know, make... You know how they do these interviews and like, I asked DC for permission. I can't believe they said yes, but they did. And so now I'm going to do it. And it's never, you read the comic, it's like, what did they say yes to that you couldn't believe that they said yes to? It was that moment where, you know, you pretended to kill Alfred, but then he wasn't really dead and it was just a trick. And then it was revealed a couple issues later, he wasn't really dead. Was that the trick? That's what you were wondering. You can't believe DC let you do that. Oh, really? Okay, sure. I just want once for, you know, the hype to live up to the hype. Just, you know, if it just make it happen. Like, you know, Batman, put them together. Who cares? You're gonna have a crisis in like, you know, 6 months later anyway. So it can all be wiped out by the, you know, the super sideways monitor who's changing reality to make way for, you know, 5G cellular connection. Why not? Go for it. Anyway, this video went off the rails a bit, so I'm sorry about that. I am looking forward to Clay Mann and Tom King's Batman Catwoman limited series. I'd love for it to be good. Please, let's have it be good. I would like to see some dynamic things from it. I don't think we're going to get those, but, you know, hey, hope springs eternal, and you never know until you try. I think Tom King, for all the beatings he's received and everything else, I think he deserves to have a 12-issue series that is meaningful and impactful and some good things happen to it. So let's hope for that. Let's have that. Let's have it go out with a bang. I think that would be a good idea. Anyway, thanks for listening. Like, subscribe, hate, whatever you feel like doing. Follow me on Twitter at Comic Perch, and thank you for listening.